Yes, because under the Affordable Care Act, I just saw this week where an average family's costs are $25,000 a year. So it's actually doing the opposite of what it was promised to do. And patients still can't pick the doctors that they want. Pre-existing conditions, they need to be protected, and I'm in favor of that, and we'll work towards that. But there are all kinds of state-based solutions, private sector solutions out there that are bringing costs down. The last thing we need is our healthcare being run by federal government bureaucrats.
And so do you think now is the time? You know, some argue during a pandemic, this might not be the time to try to make such drastic changes. Why is now the time?
Well, this fight has been going on. It's been a good fight for the last several years, including my time in Congress. And it's important because it answers the question of, you know, how much government should we have over us as individuals, especially as something as personal as your healthcare. Look, pre-existing conditions need to be protected, and I will always work, just like I did in Congress, to make sure that's the case. But these costs going up, that's no solution. $25,000 a year for the average family on the Affordable Care Act, that is not a solution. What's a solution is competition, bringing costs down, let different ideas percolate, like state-based solutions that are blooming all over our nation. That'll be the best answer to the Wuhan virus. I'm sure there'll be stopgap measures put in place by lawmakers and everything else to make sure the transition, which is what you're talking about, works out well. But as far as the lawsuit goes, we got to work, number one, to make sure that pre-existing conditions are protected. And we have to get rid of this idea that the government should be in charge of our health care. And I'll always be for those two things.
Obviously, this is already the stance of the current attorney general. But is there anything different that you would do regarding health care? Or are you pretty much in line with what Attorney General Curtis Hill feels on this topic?
Well, regardless of the issue, you have to have credibility when you go into a courtroom. When you're representing 6 million Hoosiers in state and federal courts, you have to have credibility to go into court. You have to be able to talk with your clients, like the governor and the General Assembly. Communicate is actually a huge part of our rules of professional responsibility. The Attorney General has lost his credibility, and he cannot communicate with his clients. So he's actually doing a disservice to the people of Indiana, and that's why we're running, and that's why we're going to be the next Attorney General. That's absolutely the wrong direction, and you just have to look at one number. The average family on his idea, his plan, the Affordable Care Act, the thing that he wants to keep, costs families $25,000 a year. That's not a solution. And the reason it costs so much is because government's in charge. And just like his entire career in government, that's what he's been for. We're gonna go the opposite way to let individuals find the solutions that best work for them, not cookie cutter like the Obamacare law is, and bring the cost down, and by empowering consumers in healthcare and everything else. That's what works. We have to make sure that those with pre-existing conditions still have that protection. That is something we agree on, and we can do that, but still make sure that costs come down, that people have choice, and that people can keep their doctor.